Hi, this is Jacqueline. I am back. So I am definitely going to get you guys all up to date on how I've been doing and some of the additional treatments that I've done recently. But I do want to let the dust settle on some of that. And I wanted to do a video on my most frequently asked questions. So a question that I get asked a lot is about monoclonal antibodies. And some of the questions I get are, did monoclonal antibodies help you? What symptoms did you have when you got monoclonal antibodies? How did you get them? Did you need a doctor to give you a prescription? And you know, like just how are you able to access the monoclonals? And lastly, people ask me if they should get them. So of course, as you guys know, and as I've always said, that I am not a doctor, I do not give medical advice, and that I can only give you my experience, what I have learned throughout this journey and throughout this process. So let's sort of rewind back to when I got my first dose of monoclonal antibodies. So this was last fall, September, October, 2021. When I was going on a lot of Facebook groups and I was starting to hear anecdotal stories of people who have had long COVID that were improving from monoclonal antibodies. Now, I had had a July 2021 infection, which of course we believe that that was Delta. So I was talking to people who had, at that time, there were not a ton of variants out there. There was original Wuhan, Alpha, and then Delta. So everyone in the fall of 2021 had had those original strains of the virus. So throughout talking with different people about getting monoclonals, there were some doctors throughout the United States that were giving monoclonal antibodies to people who had long COVID with a thought process that viral persisting is what was driving people's symptoms. So of course, they are not FDA approved for long COVID. They still are not. But at that time, there were some doctors that were willing to treat patients with monoclonals that had long COVID. So I was lucky enough to be treated. I went in October of 2021 and I got the monoclonal called, I'm going to read it, Bamlanivimab and Etesevimab. So Bamlanivimab and Etesevimab. So I'm just going to call it BAM. So I was able to get BAM in October. And at that time, my symptoms were mainly GI issues. I was having a lot of abdominal cramping, a lot of nausea. I really had no appetite. I didn't really enjoy eating. I would get really bad stomach pains after eating. And I was also dealing with, I believe it was brain inflammation. I felt like I wasn't even myself. Mood was affected, and depression and anxiety. I went and I got the monoclonals, and there was an absolute improvement of symptoms. I did have some HERX effects from having the monoclonals, which I did experience for a couple weeks. And you can always go back and look at my old videos if you're interested in how that whole process went down. But I, in general, noticed such a significant improvement in symptoms. So what did happen, which was not completely unexpected, was there was a resurgence of symptoms about a month later. So this puts me in November of 2021. Now, why I say it wasn't unexpected is because when someone is sick for a long period of time, the viral load is, of course, we don't know, but one dose of MABS just might not be effective enough to really take down the complete viral load. A month later in November, I did contact a concierge service. Now people ask, how did you get the MABS? You can contact concierge services depending on where you are at in the United States. If you have been exposed to COVID, they will give you monoclonals prophylactically. So you do not necessarily have to have a positive test to get monoclonals. So I was able to have a concierge service come to my house, and then that is when I got Regeneron in November of 2021. Again, I noticed a huge improvement of symptoms. Now people will ask me, were you cured? Did you recover? And the answer to that is no. The monoclonals did not cure me or make me feel completely recovered, but my quality of life was significantly improved. So it went from being in a really dark place to having a sort of a sustainable lifestyle. So this was at the end of 2021. So I do want to mention that I have other friends and other acquaintances that I know. Some people have gotten one dose for long COVID. Some people have gotten up to five doses for for long COVID. I mean, that was between them. There were doctors that were willing to give higher doses to people to help them with their symptoms. So of course, now we're at the end of the year, and what happens is that the government pulls the monoclonals because they are no longer proving to be effective against Omicron. So BAM, Regeneron, are no longer accessible. For people that may have been getting benefit from those treatments for long COVID, they're not accessible anymore. This starts into January of 2022, and just in general, monoclonals were in a very limited supply. At that time, it was sofitrimab, and I remember our local hospital telling people, don't come asking for them unless you have pre-existing conditions and you're sick. You know, like you're severe enough, but not severe enough, you know, that you can qualify, but they really were not giving them out. They were in very limited supply in early January. So then as time went on, of course, Omicron, now we have subvariants of Omicron, and then a newer map came out. A newer map came out called Bebtelovimab. So I'm just going to call it Beb. So that monoclonal came out for Omicron subvariants. So I'm not even sure if sofitrimab is being used anymore. Beb is the one that I know was being used in April, and I believe is currently being used. So that is for the Omicron subvariants. So I actually did get that monoclonal from a concierge service, but that was when I had exposure to my husband when he tested positive. We believe BA.2 when he got back from London and he tested positive, that is when I had that monoclonal antibody. So the question that I get from people is, should I get monoclonal antibodies? And of course, I can't answer that for anybody. Again, I'm not a medical doctor. Again, these are not approved for long COVID. However, back in the fall of 2021, if you had had an original strain of the virus, Delta, Alpha, and you were looking to get Regeneron or BAM, I found from my own experience and from talking with other people that those treatments were extremely effective against those variants, those monoclonals towards those variants. Right now, I really don't know. I think if you have an earlier strain of this virus, would a current monoclonal help you? It's really hard to say because the virus has mutated so much, and I'm sure that the monoclonals have also changed so much to keep up with the current variants. That being said, if you were recently infected or you were reinfected with an Omicron infection and you want to get the MABS that are available now, I think that that would make sense because these MABS are for the strain that is out there right now. So basically, when it comes down to it, I think the MABS that correspond to the variant in which they were made for is what is going to be successful for people. So therefore, earlier strains of the virus, current MABS, it's really hard to say. So I hope that clears up some questions that you may have about MABS, how I got MABS, what MABS are available. There also was a trial for something called Leronlimab. I don't even know if I'm saying that correctly, but that was a MAB that was supposed to be made for people with long COVID. There were clinical trials being done with that MAB for people in long COVID. I have not heard any updates on that. So if anyone was in that clinical trial or if anyone knows any updates or what is going on with that, that would definitely be good information to have. It would always be good to know that there are trials going on for people that have long COVID so that, of course, we can have an effective treatment that is approved for long COVID. So again, I will be back to let you guys know how I'm doing, but I hope that clears up any questions that you guys have about monoclonal antibodies. And as always, I hope you are all staying healthy and well, and be safe. Peace.
Make sure to like.